Hi, today I'm going to show you how to track your campaigns with Maxbounty and Tracking202. What we're looking at here is the campaign that I'm going to run with. And a lot of the questions that come up is what to put in the subid spot or how to use subids. And then also how to use callback pixels or URLs. So I'll do that real quick for you. Have the campaign chosen, and notice that I put for the sub ID I put test, and when I hit save pixel, we get this pop-up that comes up. So you'll see the Maxbounty URL here for the offer, and you notice that there is a URL variable called S1 which has the value of test. Maxbounty has two spots that you can use for sub IDs. There's one called S1 and another one called S2. By default, it uses S1. So what you do is grab your link. We'll leave test in here because it makes it easier to set up once you're in Tracking202. I'm going to switch over to my Tracking202 account and then paste the URL here. And then what I'll do is replace the URL variable S1 with our subid token. And so it puts subid here. Remember that Tracking202 automatically generates subids. If you want to use your own subid, do not add any variables to the end because then we do not know what the subid is. So this was MB test affiliate network, put Maxbounty. And I think the payout was 40 cents. We'll just add that. And that's it. The campaign has been added right here. So the next thing is how to get postback pixels. And what you notice down here at the bottom is the postback URL. Notice that there is a spot for amount and also a spot for sub ID. So we'll copy that and go into Maxbounty and paste. We will paste that into a text file so that it's a bit easier to look at. Okay, so here's the text file. And then when you click that look at this, you'll get some information on the different tokens that work with the postback URL. So notice that the value for the sub ID that was stored in S1 is this token here, that's S1. And then also the rate, this is the amount that you were paid for the offer, is here as a rate token. So let's modify our URL for amount. We will plug in the rate token. And then for the subid, we'll put in S1 token. Notice that these are Maxbounty tokens here and here. They're not the Tracking202 tokens. So now we'll copy this URL, and that's where what will be placed into this spot right here, and just hit save pixel, and it saves the URL, and that's it. If you were using the S2 variable, then the token would be this for subid. So it's very simple to create your tracking links and also create your callback pixel so that when a conversion happens, it's automatically fired and displays inside of Prosper202.